Have you ever wondered how you can tell whether a person really loves you? I know a lot of us, especially in our romantic relationships, have wondered about that at one time or another. What is one thing for sure, you can't go by what a person says, because many people say, "I love you," and they cheat on you, they lie to you, they do a lot of things that definitely shows that they don't love you. So I think we all know that you can't go by a person simply saying, "I love you." But there is a surefire way to tell if a person really loves you. And it's in the Bible. Read 1 John 5:3. Read John 14:15. And read John 8:29. You can tell if a person really loves you by one main thing, is revealed in how they treat you. A person who really loves you will treat you right. A person who really loves you will be very concerned about pleasing you. A person who really loves you is going to focus on, first of all, finding out what you like, finding out what pleases you, and then they're going to do everything in their power to do those things that please you so that you will be pleased, so that you will be satisfied. That's how you tell. How does the person treat you? If you find that a person is constantly trying to please you, if you find that a person's attitude is in finding out what you like and what pleases you and trying to do those things that please you, you could rest assured you have found a person that really loves you. Now, of course, nobody's perfect. So we all fail from time to time. So even a person who really loves you, every once in a while, they might fail to show it. But that's okay. You understand that we all have faults, and even you yourself fail in some instances in doing the things that you ought to do. So when they fail, your attitude should be that of being forgiving and loving and merciful. But really, to tell the truth, a person who really loves you, they won't fail most of the time. You'll find that the vast majority of the time, a person who loves you will at least try to please you all the time. They'll try. They may not succeed, but you can look at their attitude and you'll be able to tell through their attitude that they really, really love you and they're trying to find out what pleases you so that they could do those things that please you. Now, the big question is this: do you love God? How can God tell whether we love Him or not? God can tell the way we feel about Him the same way we can tell if another human being loves us. He goes by how we live. He goes by how we treat Him. How do you treat God? Are you good to God? Have you tried to find out what pleases Him? Do you read the Bible to find out what He likes and what He doesn't like, what angers Him, what saddens Him, what pleases Him? If you want to be a servant of the Lord, then that's what you have to do. You have to read the Bible so that you become acquainted with what God loves, what pleases Him, what He hates, what displeases Him, what causes Him to be sad, what causes Him to be angry. You need to know these things if you're going to serve God. If you want to love God, the way to find out how to love Him is to read His Word. And in His Word, He will teach you how to please Him, what He loves, what He hates, what angers Him, what saddens Him. And you will find that He tells you in 1 John 5:3 and John 14:15 and John 8:29, if you love him, you'll keep his commandments. What commandments? Why, the Ten Commandments, of course. Jesus Christ himself said, all the law and the prophets are founded on the Ten Commandments. And I don't know if you realize it or not, but out of everything that's written in the Bible, there's only one thing that was written by God himself, and that's the Ten Commandments. If you read the Bible, it will tell you the Ten Commandments was written by God's own finger. He didn't even use a pen. He wrote the Ten Commandments with his own finger in stone. It's etched in stone. That means permanence. And Jesus Christ himself said, all the law and the prophets are founded on the Ten Commandments. That means everything in the Bible, all the scriptures that you read in the Bible are founded on the Ten Commandments. So you show your love for God by keeping the Ten Commandments, by keeping all of his laws, all of his commandments, all of his statutes. That's how you show that you love him. Do you know the Ten Commandments? You must first learn the Ten Commandments. And then, once you learn them, you can keep them. And when you keep them, you'll be showing God that you really, truly love him. He said, by this we show our love for him, by the keeping of his commandments. And even Jesus Christ said that his Father is pleased with him because he does the things that pleases his Father. When someone does things that please you, they really bring out a good feeling in you toward them. A person who goes out their way to please you, you'll really feel good toward that person. You'll begin to really love that person. And if you already love them, that'll probably increase your love for them, because you see that they're really trying to please you. So we must try to please God. We must put forth the effort through the power of the Holy Spirit residing in us. It will lead us and guide us and help us to do the things that please God and to resist evil temptation. You can't please God on your own. You need the power of the Holy Spirit. So we must repent of our sins and ask God to give us his Holy Spirit so that we may obey him and please him. I hear people say, oh, it's so hard to keep the Ten Commandments. It's hard to live that way. It's hard if you don't have the Holy Spirit. But Jesus Christ said, my yoke is easy and my burden is light. So ask God for his Ten Commandments and be serious about serving God. Learn what he likes by reading the Bible. See what pleases him. Refrain from doing things that anger him and that displease him. And if you make a mistake and do those things, simply repent. Just go to him and ask for forgiveness. God is very merciful and forgiving. And if you're sincere, he'll forgive you. And you can start with a clean slate again. So, how do you treat God? Do you love him? Do you do the things that please him? If you do, then you know, and you can prove with your life that you really do love the Lord.